feel about this? Manny Pacquiao, Amir Khan. Are you excited about it?
I'm excited about it.
Who win?
Manny Pacquiao.
Why?
Because Manny Pacquiao still has a little bit left. Don't think that because the Mayweather fight happened, that Pacquiao has nothing left. He still has a little bit left, enough to knock Khan out. Khan got hurt by Chris Algieri.
Last night, did you watch the Ronda Rousey fight live? Did you watch it on tape? Did you hear about it?
I watched it on Instagram after the fact. You know what I'm saying?
And what went through your mind the first time you saw it? As a Mayweather fan, as a boxing fan?
When I seen her get knocked out, I was like, wow, you know, boxing does prevail, you know, in many situations.
Because Holly Holmes was a boxer? If Holly Holmes wasn't a boxer, if Holly Holmes was a wrestler or...
It might have been a different story. But, I mean, if you look at the fight, the straight left hand has Ronda, like, she was, like, frozen. You know? Every time Holly threw that overhand left, like, Ronda didn't know what to do. And then Holly was, like, ducking under stuff.
What would
you
do if someone kept throwing an overhand left at you or a straight left at you?
Pivot, move my head,
Coach.
Something like that.
Yesterday, Holly Holmes kept throwing the straight left at Ronda and caught her time after time. What is a fighter supposed to do when that happens? What would you tell her?
Well, in boxing, it's that famous matchup of southpaw versus conventional where the foot placement really matters a lot. Now, I'd have to watch an MMA fight again to see if Holly Holmes really was doing this, but I suspect that she was stepping to the outside of her foot to deliver the straight left. And then this puts the good natural defense against the right because now that right hand has to loop in order to get it. But if I were to step directly at my opponent and try to hit him with that left hand, now I have to loop around. My opponent can just come straight down the pipe. So that's always that famous juxtaposition for that position of getting that lead foot to the outside so you can deliver straights and hooks. And one of the punches I did see that her she was landing a lot too was that jab would come. She'd give it that counter hook over the top. And if you're not used to seeing the southpaw in front of you, man, it's a hell of a lot different.
Now,
it
yeah,
really
but Holly Holmes is a lightweight, a welterweight, junior welterweight champion. So she has a lot of experience in big fights.
Yeah, and in boxing, she's kind of feather fisted.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, 9 knockouts. You're right. Maybe that's what they thought. But how about this? So right now, Holly Holmes...
I guess her fucking kick is bigger than her punch.
That was a vicious kick. But then again, maybe it's the hit of the head to the floor with the kick.
Whatever.
I think she was out, though, before she even... I think
it was
she
a
might
combination of the kick and the punch.
She ran into that left hand. The left hand that staggered her, and then she got kicked.
Yeah, she already was staggered by the left hand, and she was already dizzy, and then the foot just...
And she got grounded on top of that.
So yeah. she was out.
I never thought in my life, I'll be in a gym talking about women fighting MMA in my life. It's crazy, but this may be the last one. Because it may not be...
We're lucky.
It may not be again like this.
Yeah, we're lucky.
But Brennan... Your fighters here train hard. If your fighter is struggling in a fight, is there something you could tell them to change it, or it doesn't matter at that point? If you didn't train in the gym, and even if you give them the right instruction?
No, everybody's different. Some people you can dig out of a hole. Some people continue to tumble down the mountain. It's really a personality thing. You know, some people, I've had a lot of boxers that when they're doing well, when they're kicking ass, when punches are landing for them, on top of the world, and the second they start missing or punches, they start receiving punches, it's like a downward spiral. They can't get it back together. They have other guys, you know, that they make the adjustment, you know, and that's the mark of a champion. You make the adjustment.
Why did everyone at the gym this morning tell me that in MMA you're going to lose eventually? Like, nobody's undefeated in MMA. Why? Why did they say that? Based on what? Staying in the game too long?
I think there's so many ways to lose that it's hard to focus on one or the other. Also, I will say this. I think it's so infantile as a sport that you don't really have masters and styles in the same way that boxing does, where you can match a particular style against another style and have a pretty good idea what the outcome is going to be. You know, this has happened after 200 years of
like brawler versus
paid
boxer,
paid fist fighting. You know, where this MMA, this style of MMA, it's only been around since the late 90s.
Muhammad Ali lost. Mike Tyson lost. Fedor was a legendary MMA fighter. In 10 years, he didn't have any loss. He had one technical loss, I mean, off a cut, and he lost. But eventually, he stayed in the game long enough, and he lost. He got submitted.
Yeah, if you keep fighting, you're going to lose.
So Mayweather 49-0. Does he come back for a 50th, or does he leave it alone?
I wonder what he's going to do.
I think he either fights the winner of Cotto Canelo, maybe Adrian Broner, because there's a lot of buzz. But
that would be a terrible fight.
Why? For who?
For bro, for the fans.
No, why not?
Bro, a flop. I bet you I'll put money Andre Berto could beat Adrian Broner.
No.
I'll put a fucking $100 on it, Ellie.
100? I'll put $1,000 on it.
I'll put those push-ups, guy.
Oh, wait. Do we have any push-ups coming up for Cotto Canelo?
You owe me 5,000 push-ups already.
I owe you 5,000. We did double or nothing, and I won.
If you gave me the push-ups that I wanted from you, Ellie, that you owe me, you'd probably look like an Adonis.
I'd probably look like Mr.
Olympia.
Without the steroids. There you have it. Brandon Krause, SportsCenterReport.com, and Melissa back reporting. Is it?